In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. May the love and mercy of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ be with you. Let us pray. Lord, full of love and mercy, we thank you for your goodness. Behold, we ask you, send us your Holy Spirit to enable us to understand your word, heal our fears and anxieties. This is our prayer through Christ our Lord. Amen. My dear brothers and sisters, today, Saturday, the 10th of July, 2021, the Gospel for Meditation is taken from Matthew chapter 10, verses 24 to 33. And our theme from this Gospel is, do not be afraid. This word appears 4 times in the text. The Gospel of today is still a continuation of other Gospel texts we have been meditating on in the last past 3 days. As we already said yesterday, even the text today, Jesus does not promise his disciples gold on a silver plate or a bed of roses, but he continues to prepare them for an eternal joy, but which comes with a cost. It is preceded by challenges. He begins by admonishing them not to think of being greater than their master. If they have called their master Beelzebul, the father of devils, how much more those of his household? Thus, they should be prepared to face opposition with the wisdom and innocence, remembering that their master went through the same. But they should not be afraid, since everything concealed will be revealed and all secret will be known. My brothers and sisters, are you afraid? Do you fear criticism? Do you fear witnessing to Christ among a people who are blocked by worldly pleasures? Imagine if you are in a hotel with friends but opposed to your faith. Or maybe you board a taxi with people you do not know. Is it easy for you to say a prayer, to make a sign of the cross, or you find it hard to witness to Christ? Jesus tells you, my friend, do not be afraid. Carry on. Proclaim on the housetops the message that God has given you, remembering that your gift is an eternal one. It is not short-lived. It is not worldly. It's not earthly. Therefore, he calls you to be faithful and not be afraid. Jesus tells us not fear those who kill the body but cannot kill the soul. Rather, to be afraid of God who can destroy both the soul and body in eternal fire. Do not fear the devil. Jesus has already defeated him. Nor should you fear the world, for Jesus came into it, he saved it, and succeeded. Therefore, you only need trust, and with him, you will succeed. I will succeed. Do not be afraid. Many times, Jesus appeared to Saint Faustina and told her the same word whenever she was troubled. For instance, in number 1180, Jesus tells her, my daughter, do not be afraid. My will is that you keep here. Human projects fail and should be in conformity with my will. Jesus tells her father that he never leaves us. Only a grave sin can expel him from our hearts. Nothing else. Do you see this? So what we should actually fear is sin. Never fear the world. Never fear anything. Only fear sin. Shun from sin. Jesus tells his disciples that even the hairs of their head are counted. What a beautiful thing. Can any one of us count his hair? I was imagining when Father Innocent, I'm combing my hair. How much hair falls off my head? Yet for my even don't know it. Nor do I know where it has gone. But God knows it. What would this tell us? That God knows every detail about my life. God knows every detail about your life. Therefore, do not be afraid. That is why Jesus will tell us in Matthew chapter 6, verse 8, that before we go to pray, God already knows what we need. Although, of course, it is our responsibility to trust and ask Him. Therefore, because of God's goodness, we should never be afraid. We should acknowledge Him and tell others about Him. Jesus promises that those who acknowledge Him here on earth, He will acknowledge them before His Father. And what would this mean? While on earth, it is your turn to acknowledge Jesus. And when you die and leave this world, it will be Jesus' turn to tell God about you. Are you ready to do your part? Are you ready to take your turn? Let us pray. I propose for a prayer, we say the prayer of His Eminence Cardinal Mary Del Valle, praying that God may deliver us from fear. Deliver me, Jesus, from the fear of being humiliated, from the fear of being despised, from the fear of suffering rebukes, from the fear of being calumniated, from the fear of being forgotten, from the fear of being ridiculed, from the fear of being wronged, from the fear of being suspected. And this is our prayer through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. May God of love and mercy bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen. I'm Reverend Father Innocent Yangu Regia of Kabarak Diocese, Uganda.